Predicting how quickly fire might spread is not guesswork, it's science. On the Lolo Peak Fire, a team of analysts and meteorologists work to give firefighters, fire managers, and local agencies the best information possible so they can stay safe today and plan for tomorrow and beyond.
Primary things we look at for fire behavior are, of course, the fuels, what's going to burn out there, the grasses, the trees, the brush, the topography, the lay of the land, if you will, the mountains, the hills, and then the weather.
While a fire behavior analyst focuses more on what the fire may do today and tomorrow, long-term analysts project up to 2 weeks out. Using the current weather forecast combined with local historic climate data, they create thousands of probabilities, the odds on what the fire is likely to do.
We model out potential growth for 3,000 or 4,000 fires from where the fire is located right now. And so those 3,000 or 4,000 different possible growth perimeters over that 2 week period, we sandwich those together, and that's what gives us the probabilities. The longer we're on a fire, the better we are at calibrating. Calibration is a process we use to try to match up our observed fire behavior with our modeled fire behavior. On an ongoing fire like Lolo Peak, we have lots of opportunities to calibrate our data.
That data includes an historically dry July and a part of the forest which hasn't burned in over 100 years.
We're anticipating, unless we get some significant weather relief in the next couple weeks, and right now there's nothing on the horizon that says we're going to get any relief in the form of moisture, of a pretty significant fire season in this local area that's going to challenge us and essentially allow this fire to be up there for the rest of the summer.
Like weather forecasts, fire projections may or may not come true, and unpredicted events can still happen.
As a team, we are not just focused on what we're doing today and what we're doing tomorrow. We're thinking out over a much longer time period so that when events do occur, we've had some forethought into how we're going to react, what needs to happen, you know, depending on the location of the fire. And we weave all of this together with the structure protection, the evacuation plans that have been identified, our communications with our cooperators, like the local fire departments and the county sheriffs, to kind of have everyone have a common operating picture.
Which is why this science team will keep working, analyzing, and refining their projections so firefighters and our local partners have the best information possible to protect lives, property, and the land.